going to the Olympics.
The Olympics?
Wow.
What's her name?
Gabrielle Douglas.
Gabby Douglas.
We can't afford to send her to Iowa.
You can't afford not to.
You think there aren't other little girls out there who miss their family?
You can be the best in the world.
Yeah, you can be the greatest. You can be the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest. You can be a hero. You can get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought would never be broke. Yeah, do it for your country. Do it for your name. Cause there's gonna be a day when you're standing in the hall of fame.
Imani, it's a pleasure to be with you today. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling very well, thank you. How are you?
I'm great.
Good.
I want to thank you for taking some time out for andrepresent.com. It really means a lot to us for you to do this interview today. It's a warm, beautiful day in sunny California.
Yes.
And you are here, and everybody's excited about you portraying Gabby Douglas in the upcoming film. How does it feel to be portraying such a legend?
It feels amazing. I told Gabrielle, I said I had to thank her for, you know, letting me be a part of telling such an inspiring story. So I feel very honored to be a part of it.
Now, we've all fallen in love with your character on Everybody Hates Chris.
I don't like it.
You go eat the sausage. Can you hear me? Girl, do you think I'm playing with you?
Oh, no, no.
And I can relate because I'm the younger sister in my family.
Oh, yeah?
You know? Yeah, so a lot of things that you would do in that character that, you know, I can relate. I used to terrorize my older sisters and get away with everything, you know, so can you relate to that character, you know, in a way?
Because
you kind of brought it to life. I'm trying to see if that was...
I can. I have 5 brothers, and I have 2 older brothers and 3 younger brothers. So as far as the older brothers, I wasn't as rough as Tanya. She was a little bit... but one of my older brothers, not the eldest one, but the one right above me, I guess it's kind of like
right,
Drew.
Right.
Him and I would kind of like beat each other up, but then we would love each other. But then we were like, he would eat all my cereal, so I would hide his toy cars, or I would like go in a room and slap him, and then he would like try to break my arm. So yeah, I could kind of relate with that. Yeah.
Okay. So, you know, in preparing for that role, it's like you have to bring a little bit of yourself, your real life, into
for
that.
Tanya?
For Tanya.
Okay.
Okay, so now that you're portraying Gabby Douglas.
Well, if you don't believe in me, how am I supposed to get anywhere?
Like the Olympics?
What did you have to do to prepare for that role?
I did a lot of research. I was constantly on the computer, on Google, on YouTube, just researching Gabrielle like crazy. I went to go pick up her book, My Leap of Faith, Grace, Go, and Glory. And read that book, and throughout the process going back and forth to see what information I miss. And then after booking the role, I continued to do research and I was able to communicate with Gabrielle and her mom. So if I had any questions about the character or I wanted more background story on a situation, they were there to give me more information about it. They came the last week of filming. We did get to spend some time together on set when they were there, and then we actually got together recently. I got enough information where I was able to portray her pretty well, yeah.
Okay, well that's cool that you all were able to hit it off and be cool.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
It's like, you know, the real life person and the person that's playing her.
Yeah.
Now you're an actress, of course, in your own right. You've been in this industry for a long time. You know, you're definitely not new to this.
Yeah.
You know, so when you're not on set, you're not filming, you're not auditioning, you're not doing 8 interviews in one single day like you are today. You know, what's it like in Imani's world? What do you do for fun? We just got through talking about slouching and eating food and all that. So what types of things do you do?
I'm a natural homebody. Okay. So I like to sit at home and watch Netflix or go bowling or something with friends and go to the movies. Actually, I don't really like to leave my house that much, so I call my friends and say, hey, come over, what are you doing? So everyone comes to me. So that's pretty much what I do for fun. Go to the movies, bowling, we may have game nights at our house and things like that. It's very, very chill, very normal.
Okay, so you're chill.
Yeah.
You're at home with your Netflix in the lounge clothes, curled up, tell your friends to come over. Mm-hmm. So what kind of dating life does that give them?
I don't know. I don't know what it does. I date.
Okay.
Sometimes. I'm very picky, though.
So. You should be.
I'm just very picky. You're making me blush.
Okay.
Right now. Yeah, I don't know what you want to know. I don't know what you want to know. But I date from time to time, and
actually have to leave the house to go on a date.
I do. I mean, see, I like to do stuff like that. I like dates. I think that's fun.
Okay.
Yeah. I leave the house for that.
Okay. She leaves the house for dates.
Mm-hmm.
And then you make your friends come over.
Yeah.
Netflix. So what kind of music do you listen to?
I listen to all kinds of music. I listen to dubstep, to rock, to R&B, to the blues. I listen to everything. If you could just scroll through my Pandora playlist, mm-hmm. you would just see all types
kinda
of stuff.
Kind of depends on how you're feeling that day.
Yeah. I'm not a really big fan of today's hip-hop mm-hmm. because I feel like it's so degrading, so I don't really favor that unless it has like some really cool lyrical content in it, but so I listen to all kinds of music.
That's cool that you have such a broad, you know, spectrum when it comes to your music choice. Mm-hmm. In terms of TV, movies, since you are an actress and you've acted in film, TV, etc., mm-hmm. what type of films and things do you watch?
I watch all kinds of films. I watch, like yesterday I watched this film called Stuck in Love, and I think Jennifer Connelly or something like that, she's an actress, and I just watch whatever I feel like watching.
So you like a rom, I'm gonna get excited now if you tell me you're like a romantic comedy kind of, that's my favorite genre of music.
I do, it makes me feel better.
I like the happy ending, like,
yeah.
I think that's just me.
I was kind of in a like, not so good mood yesterday, and I watched that movie, and I was like, ah! I feel so much better. I don't know what it did or what it was, but it made me feel so much better. But, just any type of film. I feel like when I watch a film, I'm learning something new. It's like studying for me being an actress. So I watch all kinds of films.
I Googled you.
Okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. That's something you hear every day. Mm-hmm. I Googled you. No. You know? So I Googled you, mm-hmm. and I was really interested in learning, you know, how you got your start. And although Google doesn't tell all of your business, mm-hmm. I did learn that you like started training, you know, for this acting career at like 7 or 8 years old. Is that true?
Yeah, that's when I decided that I wanted to do it. I was like, okay, this is.
You've made a decision as a child, like I want to be an actress.
Yep.
That's awesome.
Yep. I was like, okay, this is what I want to do. And so my grandmother kind of convinced my dad to put myself and my older brothers, because mm-hmm. my eldest brother kind mm-hmm. of fell off and he didn't want to do it anymore, but the one right above me, we continued to do it. He put us in neighborhood theater.
Okay.
And so we started doing plays at the neighborhood theater. And so I was just like, oh my God.
So that was like a test or a trial?
Yeah,
like,
but
let's see if you're really into it.
I think my grandmother kind of noticed the creative side mm-hmm. of myself. And so she's like, why don't you put them in things? And so, yeah, I fell in love with it.
Shout out to grandma.
I know. My grandmother. I know. Tell me
the real advocate, right?
Put me in theater. But yeah, so, I mean, it was something that I really, really loved, and I always wanted to outshine everyone, and so, you know, it's something that I've always loved, and I've written scripts since I was, like, 7, and directing.
7 years old.
Yeah, 7 years old.
So then I know you were in theater all through high school and all that stuff.
No. I've been homeschooled since I was in 6th grade, so.
Wow.
Because I booked Everybody Hates Chris when I was in 6th grade, okay. So. No, but I don't really care for high school, so that's not something that I feel like I missed out on, because I got to be on set and mm-hmm. actually work. So
you grew
cool.
up on set, which is really awesome. Everybody doesn't get that opportunity every day, so.
Yeah,
you know,
exactly.
You grew up on a show, you know, and exactly. It's like you have people across the country that are fans of the show that I think that are excited to see you. That's how it was when I first saw you. Like, wow, like, she's grown up. Like, yeah. And you're still playing the reruns. Like,
yeah,
like,
I know.
You're
everyone's
still,
like,
you're still Tanya Rock. Like, mm-hmm. you're still that little girl, and you're really not. Like,
I know. Everyone has been writing me on Twitter lately and on Instagram. They're like, oh, wow, I was expecting you to be a lot younger than me, and you're 20, so that's weird. And I was like, I know, you know, guys. You guys are growing up, so, you know, that means that we have to be growing up.
So, you know, you said you spoke to that, so you're getting a lot of great support and feedback from people with you being on this, in the new film?
Yeah, I am, and I think that's pretty awesome that people have been continuing to follow my career throughout this whole process, so, and supporting me as an actress. I'm really thankful and grateful for that.
Okay. One last thing before we go. Mm-hmm. If you could give some advice to a young, whether it's whether we're talking about a 7-year-old mm-hmm. or a 12-year-old or even a 52-year-old, some advice for somebody who's interested in getting started in an acting career.
I would say if you truly do love it, mm-hmm. to definitely do it, and do not let anyone tell you that you can't, because I've had people doubt me, and my own family members have doubted my ability and what I've loved, and don't let anyone tell you you can't, and have dedication and motivation and study. It's very important to study your craft and study the greats and stay in class, and you'll get there.
Who are your greats?
Will Smith and Denzel Washington, and I'm really, she's, I don't know if she's a great yet, but I really love Kerry Washington.
Mm-hmm. Those are such strong actors.
Yeah, I aspire to be Kerry Washington when I grow up.
You don't look like
Skin, no. Thank you. That's awesome.
Okay. Well, congratulations. I wish you nothing but the best in this journey. I feel like you're just getting started. Mm-hmm. And the sky's the limit for what you can do. So congratulations on everything.
Thank you. Hey, I'm Imani Hakim, and you're tuned in to AndWePresent.com. Mm-hmm.